to go into the studio full time, and it really became about creating work and not leaving printmaking, but not necessarily a complete focus on printmaking. It was about creating just in general. And so I began to sew into the work. I began to collage into the work. So you look at these works, there's definitely printmaking involved, but you'll see sewing, you'll see painting, you'll see collaging, and other elements in the pieces as well. In terms of the background and how the what the works are about, I work in series, and every time I work in a series, the next series is always a conversation on the previous work. And so these works are from a series called Night Women. And Night Women is about that spiritual space in which women inhabit. It's about a space of prayer, it's about a space of meditation, and I wanted to reference what that transition looked like with these beautiful women. What does that spiritual element of who they are visually looks like? So this piece, Constellation, again, her hair kind of referencing the constellations that we see in the sky. So just really tying into that spiritual side of who our mothers are, who our aunts are, our sisters, you know, all of these women who have helped us to become who we are. And I really wanted, I feel like it's really important to tell their story and talk about them, you know, talk about them in my work in that way. So, Night Women. So if you have any questions, let me know.
And let's look at, last but not least, is Lovey Olivia.
Hi, thanks for everyone being here. Great to see all the Houston faces in the house. Welcome everybody to Galveston. I've been here for a couple of days. I'm a little drunk on seawater.
You said drunk, so we know that's true.
salt water.
Call it what you want.
Bourbon. So I'm the most, I think, schizophrenic of the whole. I have a love affair for the history of painting, printmaking, and sculpture. And somewhere in between that space, I try to conjure up ideas and images and shapes and forms that sort of survey these observations with these art forms. Most of the time, I'm doing paintings in the form of fresco. Frescoes basically means fresh, so it means that I'm painting natural pigments without binders onto plaster surfaces which are wet, and as this plaster dries, the pigment dries with it, and now we have like a rock hard surface. The closest thing, I guess, to say to a fresco would be Roman cave paintings, European cave paintings, Italian murals, churches and things like that all used fresco and Diego Rivera, and we can go on and on and on. It's a very taxing material, it's a very complicated process, and then adding sculpture and printmaking on top of that makes me a bit more schizo, but it also makes for, you know, a happy ending. What I've done here is basically try to move away from what I typically paint. It's usually figurative and representational. And what I've done with Rue over the last few years is try to push the medium of printmaking more than the context of what's going on with the show or the title or anything like that. Just every time taking the opportunity to push the medium further than I've witnessed it pushed. So basically what I've done is a series of monotypes, monoprints. People battle with that title, so I'll say both, monoprints and monotypes. And basically, I do huge paintings or transfers onto glass, and then I pour plaster onto that surface in different shapes and forms, and then come up with a whole another form from that, which is what I've done here with She Was Made of the Best Parts of the Universe, which is this indigo piece here.
Can you hear me now?
Sorry. More than anything, I'm just excited about pushing the medium as far as I can go. There's really little story and more visual excitement. I just wanted to entertain the eye. I use a lot of indigo before I use black. If you see any dark colors in my work, it's probably derived from the color indigo or something like that. I use indigo pigment oftentimes in the works, and it just has like an important weight to me and value, much like salt is valuable, hence the title of the show. At one time, salt and indigo was as tradable as gold, and so the value of those materials and ingredients are so vital and so important in history. So I wanted to sort of represent that with just the colors. This piece here, which is titled Net Worth, I basically took a bunch of dashiki and African patterns from my travels, from patterns that people gave to me, and printed them out, transferred them. I won't go into the process, and sort of did the same thing I did with that, where I'm literally pouring the plaster instead of applying it to a wall or to a canvas or to a surface. The Dutch patterns and the African origins of these patterns and like the combination of them sort of reminded me of the history of trade and slavery and things like that. So instead of taking images of enslaved individuals and captives or capturers, I sort of use this pattern because I love patterns. Believe it loves patterns, which is why we're in this room together.
Yeah.
So instead of going on further about what you should know about the pieces, look at them and come up with what you want to know about it. So it's just visual entertainment.
Nice.